everyone, I am Vishal Soni. Today we're gonna build a LED fidget keychain. In this keychain you can play game. Turn on the slide switch on the side and you will see rainbow colors. After rainbow color, the LED will blink with one color. That is the color we have to choose. If you choose wrong color, the game will restart. As you can see, this is the green color we have to select. So that's a green color. And now we have to select red. This device can work on silent mode. To turn on the silent mode, press the button and then turn on the slide switch. As you can see, now there is no sound. So it's early morning and I have just completed my code. So as you can see, the buzzer and button and LED ring is connected with Arduino Nano. Let me reduce the brightness so you can see color better. So now you can see the colors. But let me reset the Nano so you can hear the nice crispy starting sound. So it is the starting sound, and this color we have to select. So I will press this button when blue color will show. Taking little bit. Okay, this is our blue color. Now it switched to yellow color. So in this way, this will increase its speed of 100 millisecond at every level. So this is our 3D print. As you can see, this is for sliding switch, this hole is for push button, and this is for charging. So I found out that this Arduino Nano is not fitting in the 3D print. If I fit it, then the size will be increased. So I'm using this 85, which will be a properly fit in this case, and the battery will go here. Okay, but problem is that this board actually works on 5 volt. So I have to boost the voltage from the battery. So what will I do is, I will remove the microcontroller, which is 80 tiny 85, from here, and erase all the memory, all the bootloader which already in it, and reflash it at 8 megahertz, internal 8 megahertz. So after this, it will be work on 3.3 volt which I will give from the LDO. The battery will be connected to a LDO which is 3.3 volt, and the 3.3 volt will be go in this and also in the LED ring. Okay, actually this is a DG Spark board. So if I upload the code from the DG Spark bootloader, the memory will be only 6 KB, and my code is going above 6 KB. So what I have doing is connecting this ISP programming pins to my Arduino and using this Arduino as ISP. You can watch my this video to know how to program any AVR from Arduino. So after connecting this SPI pin, just go to the Arduino IDE. Firstly, download the 80tiny board package. Make sure the board package is from Spence, because the board package from David is not able to play the buzzer sound. After this, download the code from my GitHub and then select the board with no bootloader, and here select the chip 80tiny 85. Then here select clock speed 8 megahertz internal, and then select correct port and hit on upload bootloader. This is not upload any bootloader, this is only set the fuse bits. Now click on sketch and upload using programmer. I have desoldered the Attiny85 chip from DigiSpark board and then took a zero PCB and made a cut so the Attiny85 pads are not short, and then soldered like this. Download the circuit diagram from my GitHub page and then connect like this. Now we are testing that all the circuit are working properly. Screw the slide switch on the side and then glue the TP4056, then glue the switch and then glue the buzzer. Now pack all the thing in the lower part and the LED ring will go like this. So this is all ready.